math drills. It seems to be an odd thing that in your 20s, you're faced with redoing middle school math to think about how to make it faster. However, for the case interview, that's exactly what you need to do. Hi, I'm Jenny Rae, the Managing Director of Management Consulted, and we've created hundreds of thousands of math drills to do just that, bring you right back to middle school algebra and computation. It starts as simple as one digit times one digit and works its way up to millions times millions and beyond. It focuses on refreshing your memory on fractions and thinking about percentages. And for math drills overall, it's really critical that there are three things that you focus on. Number one, you need to focus on drilling the math that is difficult for you. We see a lot of people come through, they get into math drills, and they enjoy them as a confidence building exercise. And there's something to be said for confidence, but not when you're headed into the case interview. Math drills are really important for building the core skills that you'll need when you're under pressure and on the spot. And the things that you're most likely to fall down on are not the ones that you know cold, but the ones that are the weaker areas for you. So rule number one, you have to, when you're thinking about math drills and mental math, focus on your weak areas. Number two, you need to drill math in the way that you would need to use it inside the case interview. Therefore, you need to actually talk through math drills out loud, not just focus on computing them in your head, and definitely not using cheat areas like calculators. So your focus needs to be on replicating the environment that you're going to use the math drills in. This would also be true if you use the same math drills to practice for a GMAT or a GRE or an SAT. When you're practicing the math drills, doing it in a test simulated or an interview simulated environment is going to be the most important thing. And then third, you really need to make sure that you're getting the mechanics down that focus on accuracy. So you need to use math drills that give you immediate feedback on accuracy and redo areas where you have under a 90% accuracy. Why is that important? Well, if you have only 10% that is inaccurate, it's going to be easier to catch when you're going through an interview. If you make a mistake, you'll quickly recognize the 1 out of 10 times that you compute something wrong. But if you have a larger area of inaccuracy, then you're gonna result in situations where you actually don't know what you're doing. It's also going to affect your confidence when you're working through the case. So overall, these three things, if you get those right, you're gonna have math drills. Now, from our perspective, we think it's incredibly important to give you opportunities to drill as many math drills as you want. But I would say a fourth, an asterisk key area, is if you can give yourself a benchmark against other people. Accuracy, that's pretty easy to identify. Did you get it right or wrong? But speed, you won't necessarily know if you're fast enough unless you benchmark yourself against other people or work directly with a coach. And at Management Consulted, we don't believe in being lightning fast in math. That's not the goal. 100% or at the minimum 90% accurate and speedy enough, which is usually in under than 10 seconds computing each step of the math. So if you need barometers for that, use our math drills. We have free ones and paid ones, and it would be awesome to support you in your journey to get better at mental math using math drills for the case interview. Thanks for watching.